How can something be both dead and alive at the same time? This was the question that Erwin Schrödinger was trying to answer with his famous thought experiment, Schrödinger's cat. In response to the EPR paper of 1935, Schrödinger aimed to summarize the state of quantum physics at the time.
One can even set up quite ridiculous cases. A cat is penned up in a steel chamber along with the following diabolical device, which must be secured against direct interference by the cat. In a Geiger counter, there is a tiny bit of radioactive substance so small that perhaps in the course of 1 hour one of the atoms decays, but also with equal probability, perhaps none. If it happens, the counter tube discharges and through a relay releases a hammer which shatters a small flask of hydrocyanic acid. If one has left this entire system to itself for an hour, one would say that the cat still lives if, meanwhile, no atom has decayed. The first atomic decay would have poisoned it. The wave function of the entire system would express this by having in it the living and the dead cat, pardon the expression, mixed or smeared out in equal parts.
So the sequence of events falling from the atom decaying or not decaying leads to a direct relationship with the cat being dead or alive respectively. The atom has a propensity of either being intact or decayed, and in fact can be in a state of limbo, where its fate is undecided. Physicists use so-called wave functions to cope with such situations, and in particular for calculating probabilities for either outcome. If we measure the property, we have to use a new wave function that properly accounts for the new situation, as new information on the atom's property has been obtained from the measurement. Schrödinger came up with Schrödinger's cat as a warning against naive uses of quantum formalism, where quantum particles can be in a state of superposition. This state of superposition means that quantum particles do not have the properties of what is superposed, but instead, it has a new set of properties that is created by this state of superposition. An example is a photon that is diagonally polarized. It is the result of superposition of horizontal polarization and vertical polarization. But this diagonal polarization is a new state, which should not be thought of as a mixture of horizontally polarized photons and vertically polarized photons. Schrödinger used this thought experiment to take this proposed phenomenon and apply it to a macroscopic object, in this case the cat, to illustrate the ludicrosity of a macroscopic object coexisting in contradictory states. By this example, he warned people against applying this formalism to macroscopic situations where quantum formalism is not valid. To reiterate, Schrödinger was trying to warn against the overusing of quantum formalism. You cannot carry over the laws of quantum mechanics and apply it to something macroscopic like a cat. Despite the fact that radioactive decay is governed by quantum mechanics, as soon as its signal is amplified, whether the hammer strikes or doesn't strike, it no longer has quantum mechanical descriptions or definition, so it would no longer have any superposition. Similarly, when discussing this experiment, people speak of assigning a wave function to the cat. This is completely infeasible for many reasons. One simple reason is that to create a wave function, we need to know everything about a particular object, and for a cat, we don't even know what particles to associate with it, as it breathes in and out air continuously. Moreover, if one of the cat's whiskers were to fall off, it would completely change the highly dimensional space where we have the frivolous wave function. Ironically, Schrödinger's cat has become the totem for everything Schrödinger tried to warn against. When people talk about Schrödinger's cat, the phrase both dead and alive always comes to mind, neglecting to mention that this was the exact opposite of his argument. So what really is quantum superposition? Superposition is definitely not an or, because otherwise we wouldn't see the interference patterns on a double-slit experiment. And it's definitely not an and, because particles cannot be in two places at the same time. Instead, superposition of two states is a new state where the system is in limbo and its fate is undecided. In colloquial terms, it's a bit of the and a bit of the or.